I appreciate that they have the gyroscope aiming on the Vita. I don't know how it was on the PS4, but the gyroscope aiming was, advanced. It's just that, with the touchscreen controls on the front and the back touch controls, it's a little bit hard, the aiming with the, if you're nervous, like I was at the end, it can make it even harder than easy. But this game has a lot of features and, a lot of content and a lot of extra unlockables that I haven't even touched, like larva and emblems and secret files and all kinds of things that I haven't even, Kafka drawings and stuff, but it's a big game. And I recommend anybody gets it who likes a hard challenge and a full high definition 3D action game on the Vita. I mean, a huge, huge thing. And they made this game in 2015. I don't know of any that have been released since that are like this. And I really hope other developers, I know they came out with the other company came out with their system, which, apparently has some better, maybe some features. Maybe it's bigger sticks. The throw on these sticks is a little low on the Vita, but I still love the Vita for what it is. All the touch controls, the gyroscope, and the high-definition portable graphics, and, this was a signature title that the users, the gamers, actually gave a super high score to. If you look at Metacritic, look on the right side, not on the left side, for the user scores, not the, the gamers, not the reviewers. So anyway, that's my main point of this video, and, to share my achievement with you and explain that this was a game that the reviewers passed over, the big critics passed over, but yet the gamers needed a game like this, and I really hope that Frima, Sony, and PlayStation all come together and revive the Vita and bring out more 3D third-person or even first-person action games for this system. All right, it's Henry signing out. All right, thanks. Bye.